Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can wirelessly tether your Sony A7R IV to your Mac using Capture One. To enable this to work with Capture One, you're going to need to download some software from Sony. So let's jump onto the laptop and I will show you where you can get it and how to install it.
Okay, so here we are on my MacBook Air. What I need you to do is go to your browser. I'm going to be using Safari. You're going to need to type in Sony Imaging Desktop. This is the link you want to click on. I'll put this link in the description below so it's easier for you to find. Obviously, we're going to download the Mac version. So install that DMG file. And then open this package. Nothing out of the ordinary, just install as per usual. Obviously, once you've installed all this, it's going to be much easier in future to initiate the software. But then once you've installed that, you need to locate the new software. I'm going to go and find it via Launchpad. So here it is, Imaging Edge Desktop. Click on that. And then you want to start the remote software. Yeah, so what's happened is the camera is looking for a USB cable or a network connection. Obviously, we don't have a USB connection because we're wanting to wirelessly tether. So what we need to do now is go into the camera menu, enable a few settings, and then we'll come back and go from there.
Okay, so here we are on the camera menu. I need you to scroll across to the third tab at the top. Go down to PC remote function. Make sure PC remote is switched to on. Make sure PC remote connect method is switched to Wi-Fi direct. Then go to tab 2 of that menu. Make a note of these settings because this is what you're going to need to connect to from your Mac. So make a note of the SSID and the password. You only need to enter it once, it will obviously remember it for future connections. Go back. Then you want the camera to send a low-res JPEG to the computer and then save the RAWs to the cards on the camera. So select PC and camera. Then go to tab 3. And here you want to select the 2 meg option. Now this is the low res JPEG that it fires across wirelessly to the computer. Now if you opted for the original file, that's going to be a raw file which is going to be very slow on transfer. So that's why you have this 2 meg option. I have my camera set up to record the files also to the SD cards. I have two in here. They're both 128 gig cards. So they pretty much last me for the whole day. I think it's about 200 odd files, RAW and low-res JPEGs you can store on those. Now, I record simultaneously to those cards, so I have a copy on each just in case there's an issue. So go to tab 5 at the top, little briefcase, go down to record media settings. This is how I have my camera set up. So record media simultaneous, and that's set for the images to record and mirror to the cards.
So now we've enabled those settings in the camera, we can then enable the Wi-Fi connection to the camera so we can then wirelessly tether. So I'm going to go up here and I'm going to select the network that the camera is outputting, and that's this one. Now because I've already connected, it's not asking me for the password, but it will obviously ask you for the password. If you go into your camera settings as before, you'll find the password in there. So then what you want to do is refresh this, and in theory it should pop up with your camera just here. Yeah, there it is. Double click on that. It's waiting for a response from the camera, as it says, and there we go. This is a live picture from the camera right now. So now what we need to do is start our Capture One session so we can then start shooting into Capture One. Obviously we need to show this software the Capture One folder, so there's a few settings we also need to enable to allow that to happen. I'm going to disable this viewer just for now because we don't need that. Okay, so now all that's left to do is start a new Capture One session. So go to your Capture One application, start a new session. What we need to be able to do is send the files from the camera wirelessly into the capture folder here. So to enable that to happen, we need to scroll down on the remote software and we need to click on this tab. And then we need to locate the capture folder inside the Capture One session, which is here, and click open.
So with that all set up, we should now be able to shoot some pictures straight into the capture folder on the Mac. So let's have a little look. Here we go. Yeah, there we are. So let's just take a few more. The other thing I wanted to show you is you have to make sure that hot folder is enabled. I'll show you why. Just full screen that. So let's just change the angle on the car. So what you'll see now is without that hot folder enabled, it's not going to require the latest shot. So you're going to have to keep clicking back on the images. So go into camera, click on hot folder enabled. And then we should see that image pop up. There you go. So then all we need to do is offload the RAW files. We've got two cards in here, as I said before, 228 gig cards. I'm going to take out card one and slot one. So then all you need to do is import these RAW files. So what you want to do is show it to the destination folder. I'm just going to double check it's going to the right place. So desktop, capture folder, set as import folder, import all. So now we have the RAW files alongside the JPEGs. So we have the full size files and the JPEGs. Essentially, that's everything set up now. So in the future, it's going to be much easier for you to enable that shoot session. So just to recap, all you're going to need to do is start a new Capture One session, initiate the Sony software, show that software the capture folder, and then shoot as you wish, making sure that your hot folder is enabled. And then after each shot, import those RAW files, and that is it. I hope you found this useful, and I hope you found it interesting. If you did, please hit the like button, please subscribe, please hit the bell also if you'd like to be notified of any future videos, and hopefully I will see you in the next one.